Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here, and in today's video we are checking out the brand new redesign of the Gmail web application. So we're going to be diving into what's new, what's available, and what has changed in the latest version. So guys, if you are a Gmail fan, do stay tuned. If you're brand new to Keep It Up to the YouTube channel, hit subscribe, and without further ado, let's dive in. So here we are with the brand new Gmail redesign, and I really do apologize because it did take me a little bit longer to get access to it. And that's because if you are looking to actually get access this first video to the Gmail experience, all you have to do is going over to the settings cog, and at the top there will be a little message saying try the new Gmail. So just be aware of that. Mine didn't pop up till today, which is pretty late, but you can always go back to the classic one if you don't enjoy it. Now, what I'm going to quickly do is actually go back to the classic one and show you what that looks like in comparison with the brand new experience. Now, we all know the classic Gmail design. You can see here, it is pretty basic now. Once you see the new one, you really can't go back in terms of visually experiencing things. This new version is meant to be a total UI design overhaul. There are a few new features, so let's dive in and check it out. Now, as you can see here, this is my sort of primary bay. On the left-hand side, you've obviously got all of your folders that traditionally stay along that left-hand side. You've also got this new main menu that allows you to cut it down. So if you were to able to learn all of the icons, or even just hovering over them will bring them up. So if I wanted to skip to send folder, for example, I could, and I have a little bit more space, which is quite nice. Now you have this new compose button on the left-hand side. So if I hit compose, this window gets brought up. And of course, there's only some slight modifications in here in terms of design. Down in the bottom right-hand corner, you've got obviously this ability to change stuff. But apart from that, there's not really any radical changes in terms of the design here. I'm going to demonstrate a quick send email and what that looks like, because what will happen is you will see that in the bottom left-hand corner, this appears, an undo send message, and you can quickly do that. And once you undo send, it will bring you back to the initial compose window, which is a, it's been a feature they've had for a little bit, but only accessible through settings, and they've made that widely available. Now, of course, there are some of the changes that have happened on the left-hand side. Things have just gotten a little more material designy, which is quite nice. Now, of course, we know that Google are rolling out their new font, and you can see that in this case. You can see the nice new font. They haven't actually fully updated it in some areas, but that's not really a misdemeanor. So you can see I've still got these sort of separations that Google created, the configure inbox a while ago. So that's not changed at all. But on this right-hand panel, I'm really getting my right and left wrong today, you can see that there are three additional things, as well as a plus button for adding more add-ons. So you can see here, you can now access calendar through your actual applications, which is impressive. So for example, let's say I'm dealing with some emails here, and I'm like, okay, I need to find a time. Okay, what am I actually doing next Thursday? You can actually go to that time, and of course, scroll through the date, as well as if you wanted to open it up in a new tab. And of course, skip back to today if you wish. And within here, you can plot out different calendar items. So this is a very nice additional feature in the experience. And it's something that Google, I think, have been meaning to squeeze calendar in there for a while, but it's more of a workspace addition. So that's really all that it does. The only other thing that it does is if you want to check out a certain calendar event or even edit it, all you have to do is click into that one. And if you press X in the corner, it just hides it away, so you don't necessarily have to use this experience. Now here we are in Google Keep. We all know Google Keep is the note-taking experience here. So here we are, the notes are already in line, which is great. You can see some of my checklists for the holiday and some information about the Rome trip I went on. But you can see here, you can actually take notes along your Gmail, which is amazing. So for example, let's say you're like composing an email and you're like, okay, I actually need to get a few things done. You can just start getting going on it. The only other thing you can do is create a list as well. So if there's a list specific item, so they're the real two ones you can create. but they appear really nicely in this sort of card-like format, which I really like. And of course, you can tick off, You can tick off items inside of that, which is impressive. As you can see, I haven't used Google Keep for a fair while, although I do really credit the experience. And like I said before, you can even go out here. Now, I'm not sure whether there is a search experience. I can't actually see it, but I'm sure they'll be able to add those small additional tweaks. Now, you've also got a new experience down here called Google Tasks, and this is something I'm going to do a separate review on separately, but it's essentially allowing you to store all of your most important tasks and making them more definable inside of Google. It's a task manager. They've just released it. So you've also got the Get add-ons here. You can also add the likes of Trello, and that will all merge in when you Google. But again, I'm not sure all of these are tailored to the new experience. So just be aware of that. That's a Google Suite Marketplace. Now, I'm just using a simple Google account, although I do have a full Google Apps for Work suite, and it seems to be working really well on this. Now, the only other additions you've got, so for example, I'm just going to send an email to myself to demonstrate this. Hello, Francesco. You've got a few other sort of functions that you can use, and then I'm going to show you the settings folder. So here we are. A file from me has been sent. So you can see here the design has slightly tweaked in this one. Of course, you can, here we go, you can go into this email and reply. Of course, they do have the quick reply function, which is available in more of the iOS application. But you can see here that they've got the traditional functions all down here, being able to filter, report, etc. So nothing in great deal has changed in terms of this experience. So it's still a pretty number one experience. Now, on this side, you've got the ability to snooze the email. Snoozing an email is very similar to Outlook and Newton. You can basically snooze it for tomorrow, and it will appear tomorrow in your inbox, which is impressive. So that's just something they've looking to add. Of course, you can still pin stuff, and you can snooze from up here, actually, now, which is very useful. So apart from that, that is the only real extra addition to that side of the stuff. Now, I just want to show you the settings. Of course, you've got the display density. I've actually just changed it to default one, I believe, but you can change that in there. You've also got themes. I'm not sure they're going to customize exactly to the new experience, but it's definitely worth checking that out if you're a real hardcore Googler. And so you can see here the undo send I demonstrated earlier, you can actually extend it to 30 seconds, which is a little longer, which is pretty good, allowing you to undo that email. You can actually have conversation view as well, that groups all of the items together. Again, this hasn't really greatly changed from the experience last time. You've also got the ability to change all of your other items too. Now, on this side, you've got labels, inbox. Nothing's really, again, greatly changed in this experience. You've got filters and blocks and forwarding and add-ons and chat, advanced, etc. And these are the more advanced settings. So you can have a preview panel on the right-hand side. So these might be for the more sort of techie, nerdy people out there who want to go crazy with their Google experience. So there are some of the major changes in the new Gmail. I will also be trying to do a Medium article on this. There are a few new features in terms of like self-destruct and things like that, but I don't really want to show you that in today's feature. It's something that I probably will feature in the software pulse or even just another feature very soon. So guys, I really appreciate you stopping by today. If you're brand new to the YouTube channel, make sure to hit subscribe. If you want to hear more about Gmail, let me know in the comments below. But guys, I really appreciate you stopping by. So make sure to have a great week, keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.